हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू संकल्प सीईटी क्लासेस। सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द कंसेप्ट एंड फ्यू क्वेश्चंस ऑन द चैप्टर लीनियर इनइक्वालिटीज एंड लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम्स। सो फर्स्ट टू स्टार्ट विथ वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग लीनियर इनइक्वालिटीज। सो इफ आर टू नंबर्स और अल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस आर रिलेटेड बाय द सिंबल्स greater than, less than, greater than equal to, or less than equal to, then they are said to be a linear inequality. They are said to be forming an inequality. An expression of the form ax plus b less than c, ax plus b greater than c, ax plus b less than equal to c, or ax plus b greater than equal to c, where a, b, and c are real numbers, with a not equal to 0 is called a linear inequality. Okay, so out of the four expressions, any expression is an example for linear inequality in one variable x. So examples: 3x plus 5 greater than equal to 4, 2x minus 3 less than 5, 3x minus 2 greater than 3, and etc. So every linear inequality has a solution set. A solution set of an inequality is the set of all real numbers that satisfy the inequality. The method of finding the solution set of an inequality is known as solving the inequality. When we consider linear equations, we have various methods to calculate: simplification method, substitution method, elimination method, to calculate the value of unknown variable. Similarly, here in case of linear inequalities, there are methods to calculate the solution set of the inequality. During the process of solving an inequality, following rules are followed. So the rules which we use for solving algebraic expression, the same rules are applicable, but because of the sign notations involved here, because of these sign notations over here, one or two rules are different. The inequality does not change if we add or subtract the same number on the both sides of the inequality. Okay, so the signs for equal to sign and inequality are almost same, but there is change only in the third rule here. The inequality does not change if we multiply or divide both the sides by the same positive real number. Okay, so whenever you are adding or subtracting or multiplying or dividing by the same number, and that is by the same positive number, there is no sign change. Okay. Next, the inequality reverses its direction if we multiply both the sides of the inequality by the same negative number. But when we make use of a negative number, when we make use of a negative real number, there is change in the direction. So this less than, okay, less than, whatever the less than symbol is there, okay, it turns into greater than. Okay, less than equal to will change into less than equal to will change into less than equal to will change into greater than equal to, and so on. So this is happening only when we multiply it by a negative real number. Okay, the rest of the rules are same. Next, now two or more linear inequalities in one variable are together said to form a system of linear inequalities. Okay, as we have system of equations, same way there is a system of linear inequalities. Next, absolute value of a real number, that is the mod function. So we all know the modulus value of x. Okay, mod x, we know the definition for mod x and definition for mod x. Okay, so mod x, it takes two values. Okay, it will be equal to x and it will be equal to minus x. So it will be equal to x when x is greater than equal to 0, when x is greater than equal to 0, and it will be equal to minus x when x is less than 0. Okay, so absolute value is nothing but the modulus function, what we have discussed in the NCERT syllabus. Okay, so next few more points we will be discussing. The next point is results associated to absolute value of real number. So for any real number x, modulus of x is greater than equal to 0, and for any real number x, when mod x is less than equal to a, it implies x is greater than minus a and less than equal to a. Okay, it implies that x is greater than a and less than equal to minus a and less than equal to minus a. Similarly when x is greater than a, similarly when x is greater than equal to a, x is greater than equal to a or x is less than equal to minus a. So we need to remember this. See, when x is less than equal to a, it satisfies the condition x is greater than minus a and less than equal to a. But when x mod x is greater than equal to a, it implies that x is greater than equal to the positive value of a and x is less than equal to minus a. So this point we will be using when x mod x is greater than equal to a, and this point we will be using directly now to solve the examples when x is mod x is less than equal to a. So based on that, same in detail we have here x is less than a. See, this is a slack inequality. Slack inequality, equal to sign will be not there. So x is greater than minus a, less than a. Similarly, when slack, when we have equality, see, along with less than sign, there is a equal to sign here. So mod x less than equal to a, so it will be x greater than equal to minus a and less than equal to a, and x will belong to the interval minus a, closed interval minus a. Here it will be belonging to the open interval. It will belong to the open interval. Next, apply the second definition what we have discussed here. See, using this second definition we are writing the point number 3 and 4. So point number 3 here is x is greater than a. So when x is greater than a, when x is greater than a, we have mod x is greater than a, x is less than minus a, or x is greater than a. Similarly here, when x is greater than equal to a, we have x is less than equal to minus a, or x is greater than a. And here in this case, see, x is less than minus a. Less than minus a, meaning of that is it can take all the values up to minus infinity. So here we have minus infinity to minus a, and x is greater than a, it implies it can take all the values larger than a. So union a to infinity. Similarly, when x is greater than equal to a, x is less than equal to minus a, and x is greater than equal to a. So here we have a closed bracket at minus a and closed bracket at plus a. The rest of the steps are same. Next, now instead of x, some other variable. See here, we had only monomial x term. Here we have a binomial with the same property, x minus a less than equal to b. Then we have a minus b, x is greater than a minus b and it is less than a plus b. Similarly, when we have mod of x minus a greater than equal to b, x is less than equal to a minus b and x is greater than equal to a plus b. Next, rational algebraic inequalities. The inequalities of the form px upon qx greater than 0 और पी एक्स अपॉन क्यू एक्स लेस देन इक्वल टू जीरो, पी एक्स अपॉन क्यू एक्स ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू जीरो, और पी एक्स अपॉन क्यू एक्स लेस देन इक्वल टू जीरो, वेर पी एंड क्यू एक्स आर पॉलिनोमियल्स इन एक्स आर कॉल्ड एज रैशनल अल्जेब्रिक इनइक्वालिटीज. ओके, सो टू इनइक्वालिटीज आर इन्वॉल्व, दे आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ फ्रैक्शन, दे आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ फ्रैक्शन. So next few points we will be discussing regarding the linear programming problems. Okay, so linear programming problems, again the basis of linear programming problems, the basis of linear programming problems are linear inequalities. Okay, are linear inequalities. So based on the inequalities, based on the study of inequalities, based on the study of inequalities, we can discuss. So based on the study of inequalities, based on the study of inequalities, we can discuss the linear programming problems. So in linear programming problems, what we do is, a linear programming problems deals with, okay, it deals with the optimization. It is dealing with the optimization process, that is either it is helping us to calculate the maximum value or minimum value of a linear function of two variables known as the objective function. And this objective function is subjected to conditions that the variables are non-negative and satisfy a linear inequalities, okay, linear inequalities called linear constraints. So a linear programming is a special type of optimization problem. So in linear programming problem, we are calculating the maximum or minimum value of the linear function, of the linear function, which is also called as the objective function, using the subjected to the given constraints. And these constraints are non-negative linear inequalities. Next, objective function. So just now we discussed z equal to ax plus b, where a and b are constant, which can be maximized or minimized, is called a linear objective function. Next, decision variables are the variables x and y involved in the objective function. Constraints, the linear inequalities or restrictions on the various LPP are called as what? Constraints. So the linear inequalities which are present to obtain the maximum or minimum value of the objective function are called as constraints. Next, feasible region, the common region determined by all the constraints, including the non-negative constraints x greater than equal to 0, y greater than equal to 0 of an LPP. And this x greater than equal to 0 and y greater than equal to 0 are also called as non-negative constraints. Next, feasible solution. Feasible solution, points within and on the boundary of the feasible region, okay, of the LPP form a feasible region. So all the points which are present in the feasible region gives us feasible solutions. Next, infeasible solution, any point outside the feasible region, outside the feasible region, is an infeasible solution. Next, optimal solution. So any point in the feasible region that gives us the optimal value, that is the maximum value or the minimum value of the objective function, is called as the optimal solution. So in feasible region, suppose if this is the feasible region which is formed by the inequalities, if this is this triangular region is the feasible region, so all points present inside the feasible region are called as feasible solutions. They are called as feasible solutions. But out of all these points, there is one point or two points which give us the maximum or minimum value. They are said to be the optimal solutions. They are said to be the optimal solutions. Optimal solutions. Okay. So next we will discuss the method of calculating the solution region or the feasible region of a given objective function. So next, the method of finding the solution region of an LPP. So in the first step, we are finding the feasible region of the LPP by determining its corner points either by inspection or solving the two equations of the lines intersecting at that point. Okay, so first we are plotting the inequalities and determining their region, and based on the common solution region, we are finding out the feasible region. Next, we are evaluating the objective function at each corner point. So let m and m respectively denote the largest and smallest values of z. So capital M, it denotes the maximum value. Small m, it denotes the minimum value. So when the feasible region is bounded, two cases we have, m and m are respectively the maximum and minimum values of z. So in first case, in bounded case, directly whatever the answers you get, after substituting the values of x and y, that is the corner points in the objective function, whatever the maximum and minimum value we are getting, those are giving us the value of m and m when the region is bounded. But when the region is unbounded, and the region is unbounded, m is maximum value of z. If the open half plane determined by ax plus by greater than m has no point in the common with the feasible region, okay, with the feasible region. So if there is no point in common, then m is the maximum. Similarly, m is the minimum if open half plane determined by ax plus by less than m has no point in common with the feasible region. So if there is point in common, if there is no point in common, then these values will be maximum or minimum. But if there is point in common, then such a region has no maximum, no minimum. And for a given objective function, there can be multiple optimal points. So if two corner points of the feasible region are optimal solution of the same type, both produce the same maximum or minimum, then any point on the line segment, on that complete line, any point is an optimal solution of the same type. Okay, so suppose point A and point B are the two optimal values, then any point on the line joining the point A and the point B, any point gives us the optimal solution. Any point gives us the optimal solution. So the second point, this here they have deleted, unbounded case they have deleted. Bounded case you all have for your studies. Okay, so you need to remember both the cases, but from CET point of view or from this year point of view, you focus on the bounded case. Next, we will be discussing examples based on linear inequalities and linear programming problems. So next part. So the first question on linear inequalities. So the first question here is, the solution set of the equation x belongs to R, where the inequality is 4x plus 3 less than 6x plus 6. So we need to calculate the solution set of this inequation. So 4x plus 3, okay, 4x plus 3, solve it in the usual way how you solve algebraic equations. X plus 3 is less than 6x plus 7, or see 3 minus 7 is less than 6x minus 4x. Okay, unknown variables on one side, numbers on one side, minus 4, and then we have 2x. So see, till when you don't divide with a negative number or you don't multiply with the negative number, there is no sign change. If you divide it by positive, there is no problem. Okay, so here I am dividing it by minus 2. Yeah, I am dividing it by plus 2. So there is no need of changing the direction. The direction will remain the same. So it will be minus 2 less than minus 2. So x is greater than minus 2. So x is greater than minus 2 can also be written as x is greater than minus 2. So the option B, okay, the option B gives us the right answer. Okay, so the option B is the right option. Option B gives us the right option. Next example. Example number two. Again, we need to calculate the solution of the inequation 4x plus 3 less than 6x plus 7 when x is an integer. Okay, so first you can again find out the solution set for this. Find out the solution set, and then instead of writing in the form of interval, here we need to write it in the form of set. So 4x plus 3, okay, less than 6x plus 7. So again, same 3 minus 7, 6x minus 4x, or minus 4 is less than 2x, or we can write it as minus 2x. So see, x is greater than minus 2. So out of the given options here, out of the given options, option A, B, and C, see, option A is starting from 0. Here it is starting from minus 2, minus 1, and 1. So since x is greater than minus 2, all the values of x greater than minus 2 are applicable in option B. So option B is the right option. Option B is the right option. Next question. So the question number 3 is solution of the inequation x plus 5 upon x minus b less than equal to 0 is. Okay, so we need to calculate the solution region for the rational inequality. See, this is a rational inequality. So when a rational inequality is of the type, okay, when the rational inequality is of the type x minus a upon x minus b, x minus a upon x minus b less than equal to 0, okay, less than equal to 0, then always this is a shortcut point here. Okay, so x minus a, x minus b, see here it is of the form x plus 5 and x minus 2, but when the inequality is of the form x minus a, x minus b less than equal to 0, then always x will belong to the interval closed at A and open at B. Okay, closed at A, that is closed at the numerator, okay, closed at the numerator and open at the denominator. So this particular, using this result, we can solve this example directly. So say x plus 5 upon x minus 2 is less than equal to 0, x minus 5 and x minus 2 is less than equal to 0. First, I'll convert it in standard form to make use of the result. X minus of minus 5 plus 5 can be written as x minus of minus 5, x minus 2 less than equal to 0. So now when we compare, we get the value of a as minus 5 and value of b as 2. Okay, value of b as 2. So when we compare it with this result, we get the value of a as minus 5. A is minus 5 and a is minus 5 and b is equal to 2. Okay, b is equal to 2. So the answer for this will be closed at minus 5 and open at 2. Okay, open bracket. This is small bracket. And here we are making use of a square bracket for closed interval. So when we consider it is closed, so it will be less than equal to, and this is only less than. Okay. So out of the given options here, the option A will be the right option. So see here, this part, I can again write it in the form of set also. We can write it in the form of set, or we can write it in the form of set. Okay, it is closed at A, so A, and since it is open at B, okay, only we are making use of less than sign, whereas here we are making use of x greater than equal to. So whenever the closed interval is there, we are making use of these symbols. Okay, and whenever open intervals are there, That is, we are making use of these symbols for less than and greater than. So this already you have studied in your board syllabus, okay? These sign notations. So using that, we have simplified this. We are writing this interval in the form of solution set that will be x. So this is in interval form, this is in set form. So x is greater than equal to minus 5 and less than equal to 2 is the answer. The next question, question number 4. So the solution set of the inequation x minus 4 upon x plus 1 is greater than equal to 2. Okay. So the previous example we solved using the result. Okay. We made use of the result of the rational inequality, that is x minus a upon x minus b is less than equal to 0, then x will belong to, okay, x will belong to the interval a and open at b, that is x is greater than equal to a and less than b. Okay, this is what we used. Okay, but this is useful only when the inequality is less than equal to 0. But here you can see there is 2 on the RHS, so we will simplify it. Okay, so we will simplify it further. So x minus 4 upon x plus 1, this 2 I will shift it to the RHS, so is greater than equal to 0. On simplifying, we get x minus 4 minus 2x minus 2 all divided by x plus 1 greater than equal to 0. On simplifying, we get minus x minus 6 divided by x plus 1. Okay, x plus 1 greater than equal to 0. Greater than equal to 0. Greater than equal to 0. Next, we are taking minus sign common here. So when we take out minus sign common, it will be x plus 6 divided by x plus 1 greater than equal to 0. So when we divide by minus sign on both the sides, the direction will change. The direction of the inequality will change. So x plus 6, x plus 1 less than equal to 0. Or by making use of the same result, we can write it as x minus minus 6, x minus minus 1 less than equal to 0. So when we compare this equation with the result we had discussed earlier, that is x minus a upon x minus b less than equal to 0, then the final answer will be of the type x belonging to a, closed at a and open at b, the interval which is closed at a and open at b. So a value is minus 6 and b value is minus 1. So closed at minus 6, open at minus 1. So the option D, okay, the option D will be the right option. Option D will be the right option. Next example, question number 5. So the solution set of mod of 4x minus 3 less than 12 is. Okay. So in CET 2015 and 16, similar type of question has occurred. Mod of 4x minus 3 less than equal to 27 is. So here again we are making use of the result. We are making use of the result. If mod of x is less than a, if mod of x is less than a, then okay, x is greater than minus a and less than a. X is greater than minus a and less than a. So using the same result, we can simplify it further. See, we can write it as 4x. We can write it as 4x minus 3 is greater than, okay, is greater than minus 27 and less than plus 27. Less than plus 27. So 3 I will shift it on the both the sides, so it will be minus 24 less than 4x and less than 30. On dividing both the terms by 4, we get minus 6x less than 30 upon 4 will be equal to 15 upon 2. It will be equal to 15 upon 2. So on simplifying, we get x belongs to the set open interval minus 6 and 15 by 2. Okay, 15 by 2. So since there is only x is less than, greater than and less than, there is no equal to symbol, so we need to make use of open interval. So out of the given options, the option D is the right option. Here it should be plus 15 by 2. Okay, plus 15 by 2, and the option D is the right option. Option D gives us the right option. Next example. If minus 3x plus 17 is less than equal to minus 13, and then x belongs to 10 to infinity. Okay, closed at 10 and open at infinity. X belongs to minus infinity to 10, and x belongs to minus 10 to plus 10. Okay, minus 10 to plus 10. When you are solving such type of questions, you need to be very careful. You need to see the brackets very carefully. Okay, so first we will simplify it. Minus 3x plus 17. Okay, plus 17 less than equal to minus 13. Okay, less than equal to minus 13. Less than equal to minus 13. So minus 3x. Minus 3x is less than equal to minus 13 minus 17. It will be 30. Or x is greater than. See, we are dividing by minus 3. So the sign will change. And 30 divided by 3 will be 10. So x is greater than 10. So open interval 10. And it can take all the values greater than 10. So x is greater than 10. So the right option will be option A. Option A will be the right option. So it can take all the values greater than 10. Up to infinity. So the option A gives the right answer. So the next question is, if mod of x minus 1 is greater than 5, then. Okay, so here again we are making use of the result. So we are making use of the result, mod of x, see, greater than a. So if mod of x is greater than a, then x will take the two values, that is x will be less than minus a or x will be greater than plus a. So using the result, we can write this inequality as this mod. Say x minus 1 is less than minus 5 and x minus 1 is greater than 5. So on simplifying, we get x is less than minus 4 and x is greater than 6. So this can be written as So x minus 1 is less than minus 5 and x minus 1 is greater than 5. So on simplifying here, we get x less than minus 4 and x greater than 6. So x less than minus 4, x less than minus 4 can be written as, x less than minus 4 can be written as, x belongs to, say, less than minus 4, so it will be minus infinity and 4, okay, minus infinity and 4, and x greater than 6 can be written as x belongs to 6 up to infinity. So when we unite these two, that is the union of these two, will give us the right answer. So option C gives us the right answer. Next example. So the next example is, if mod of x plus 2 is less than equal to 9, then. So again, it is based on the result mod of x is less than equal to 9, then it implies less than equal to a. Okay, I'll consider it as a, so minus a, x is greater than equal to minus a, and less than equal to a. So we are making use of this result and simplifying. So mod of x plus 2 can be written as minus 9 less than equal to x plus 2 less than equal to plus 9. So when we simplify this, minus 9 minus 2, it will be minus 11, and 9 minus 2, it will be 7. So on simplifying, we get x belongs to the interval minus 11 and 7. So the option B will be the right answer. So here we have make use of the basic result. Basic result, mod of x less than a. Mod of x less than a. Next example. Solution of linear inequality in variable x represented by the line. Okay, represented by the line. So this is a number line which is representing us the solution of x, the solution of x. Okay, so x 9/2. Okay, 9/2. See this dark circle. It indicates. See the shaded circle. It indicates 9/2 is included. Okay, if it would be an open circle, if it would be an open circle without any shade, it means that 9/2 is excluded. 9/2 is excluded. So when it is open, you will get an open interval at 9/2. But since now it is darkened, you will get a closed interval. So closed interval at 9/2, and all the values greater than 9/2. So up to infinity. So the option B will be the right option. Okay. So 9/2 up to infinity. And always infinity, there is no particular value, so you get a open interval at infinity. Next, another similar question. Solution of linear inequality in variable x represented by the line. So see, the question is almost similar to the previous one, but instead of a dark circle, a open circle, that is a unshaded circle is there at 5. So unshaded means it is open at 5, and the arrow mark is in the darkened arrow mark is towards infinity. So 5 to infinity. Okay, 5 to infinity. So out of the given option, option D is the right option. Option D gives us the solution region of this arrow diagram. Next question. Number of pairs of consecutive odd integers, both of which are larger than 8 and such that their sum is less than 34 is. Okay, so we need to calculate the number of pairs of consecutive odd integers. Consecutive odd integers. So here I will be considering the first odd integer, the first odd integer as x. So the next odd integer will be x plus 2. Okay, so the first part of the sentence, they are saying both the numbers are larger than 8. So x is greater than 8 is one condition, and then the second condition is their sum is less than 34. So x plus x plus 2 is less than 34, is less than 34. So 2x plus 2 is less than 34, or x plus 1 is less than 34 upon 2. Or on simplifying further, x plus 1 is less than 17, or x is less than 16. So x will is greater than 8 and x is less than 16. Okay, so it is greater than 8 and less than 16. So the odd numbers are 9 and 11. Next 11 and 13 and 13 and 15. So altogether there are three pairs. Okay, we get three pairs. So the option C is the right option. So the next question, solution of mod of x minus 1 greater than equal to mod of x minus 3 is, so we need to calculate the solution set for the given inequality. So mod of x minus 1 greater than equal to mod of x minus 3. So here we have three cases. Okay, we have three cases. So the first case is, a mod of, see here the number line, the values are between 1 and 3. The values are between 1 and 3. So when x is less than 1, when x is less than 1, the case 1, x is less than 1, the case 1 will be, both will be negative. X minus 1 will be, x minus 1 will be greater than equal to minus x minus 3. Okay, apply the mod function definition here. So when we are taking less than a, okay, less than a, that is less than 1, both will be negative. So on simplifying further, we get, on simplifying it further, we get minus x plus 1 greater than equal to minus x plus 3. X and x will cancel, so it will be 1 greater than equal to 3, which is not true. Okay, so this cannot be possible, this is not possible. Next, second case, case 2. So in the second case, we have x is greater than 1 and less than 3. So see, when x is greater than 1, this will be positive and this will remain negative. So we have minus x minus 1 greater than equal to x minus 3. So this will be minus x plus 1 greater than equal to x minus 3. On simplifying, we get, on simplifying, we get greater than equal to, this will be 4 and this will be 2x, or x will be on simplifying it further, we get 2x is greater than equal to 4. 2x is greater than equal to 4. So here this will be positive. In the second case, this will be positive, this will be negative. So minus 1. So on simplifying, we get, see here, this will be plus x minus 1 greater than equal to x minus 3. So on simplifying, this will be negative. This will be negative. The second term will be negative. See, pay attention. When x is greater than 3 and less, greater than 1 and less than 3, the first part will be positive. The second part will be negative. It will be negative. So here we have x plus x minus 1 and minus x plus 3. Minus x plus 3. So this 2x will be greater than equal to 4, or x will be greater than equal to 2. Okay. And x greater than equal to 2 is for the second case. Next, for the third case, we have, for the third case, when x is, when x is greater than 3. So when x is greater than 3, both will be positive. So x minus 1 will be positive, as well as x minus 3 will be positive. And on simplifying, we get minus 1 is greater than minus 3, which is true. Which is true. Okay. So out of the three cases, the solution set we are obtaining for the second case. So the option B is the right option. Option B is the right option. The next question is from LPP. The shaded region in the following figure is solution set of the inequations. Is the solution set of the inequations. Okay. So here four options are given. We need to go with trial and error. Okay. So to first we will check for the first inequality. In all the four cases, the same inequality has been given. The same inequality has been given. So here we have 3x plus y. Okay, 3x plus y. I'll be considering less than equal to 9. Okay. So see, when I substitute x is equal to 0 and y x is equal to 0, the equation will be 3x plus y is equal to 9. So when x is equal to 0, y will be equal to 9. And when y is equal to 0, x will be equal to 3. Okay, so 2 points we get. The first point is 0, 9, and the second point is 3, 0. And in this inequality, when we check its solution region, when we check the solution region for this, this will be 0 plus 0 less than equal to 9, 0 less than 9, less than equal to 9. It is true. And the solution region, see, for this first line, the solution region is towards origin. So we have shaded. Similarly, I'll consider the next inequality. The next inequality, I'll consider x plus 2y. Okay, x plus 2y less than 8. Okay, x plus 2y less than 8. Okay, see, whenever we consider the region as less than, the chances of obtaining solution region towards the origin or bounded case is maximum. So bounded case is maximum when it is less than equal to or less than. So for these inequalities, the bounded case is maximum. So check the options where this bounded case is there. So less than case is 8. First option cannot be there. So third option, go with third option. So again, when x is equal to 0, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 4 we get. And when y is equal to 0, x is equal to 8. So we get 8, 0. And again, when we substitute 0, 0 in this inequality, we get 0 plus 0 less than equal to 8. 0 plus 0 less than equal to 8. So 0 plus 0 less than equal to 8 is again true. So again, the shaded region will be towards the origin. So the option C, will give us the right set of inequations. So the option C gives us the feasible region or the shaded region. The next question is feasible region for ILPP is given in the figure. They are asking us to calculate the maximum of z is equal to 4x plus 3y occurs at the point. So four corner points are given, 0, 8, 2, 5, 4, 3 and 9, 0. We need to calculate the maximum value of z. So you need to go with trial and error method here. So first case, in the first case, z is equal to, say, x is 0. So 4 into 0 will be 0 and 3 into 8 will be 24. So the first value is 24. In the for the second point, 2, 5, x value is 2. So it will be 8 and 3 into 5, it is 15. It is equal to 23 for the second point. For the third point, z will be equal to, see, 4 into 4, it is 16 and 3 into 3, 9, which is equal to 25. And for the fourth case, z is equal to 4 into 9, it is 36, and 3 into 0 is 0. So the value is 36. So at fourth case, the value is maximum. So the option D, 9, 0 is the right option. 9,0 is the right option. So the next question is the corner points. Okay, the corner points of the feasible region determined by the system of linear constraints are 0, 3, 1, 1, and 3, 0. So the corner points have been given. Three corner points have been given. And let z equal to px plus qy, where p and q is greater than 0, condition on p and q so that the minimum of z occurs at 3,0 and 1,1 is 3,0 and 1,1 is. So they are saying the minimum value of z is occurring at two points, that is 3,0 and 1,1. So when we substitute these two points in the given objective function, we will get the condition for px and qy. So first I'll be substituting the first point. So when I substitute the first point, that is 3,0. So when I substitute 3,0, the value of z will be equal to, see, the value of z will be equal to 3p plus 0. And when I substitute the second point, 1,1, okay, 1,1, z will be equal to p plus q, okay, p plus q. And both are the values of z, minimum values. So we can equate it, 3p will be equal to p plus q, or 2p will be equal to q, or p will be equal to q by 2. Okay, it will be equal to q divided by 2. So the option B gives us the right answer. Option B gives us the right answer. Next question. Next question, the corner points of the feasible region determined by the system of linear constraints are 0, 10, 5, 5, 15, 15, 0, 20. Let z equal to px plus qy, where p and q are greater than 0. Then condition on p and q so that the maximum of z occurs at both the points 15, 15 and 0,20 is. Okay. So they are saying the maximum value of the objective function is occurring at the two points. So using these two points, we need to calculate the condition between p and q. Okay. So for the first point, 15,15, for the first point, 15,15, z will be equal to, so z will be equal to 15p plus 15q. And for the second point, 0,20, z will be equal to, zero into p is zero, and this will be 20q. It will be 20q. So equate both the values. So on equating, we get 15p plus 15q is equal to 20q, or 15p is equal to 5q, or p is equal to 1/3q. Okay, 1/3q, or q will be equal to, and q will be equal to, q will be equal to 3p. Q will be equal to 3p. So the option D will give us the right option. Option D will give us the right option. So from this chapter, we have discussed few examples. And both the chapter will include one question in CET. One question is fixed every year on inequalities, and one question is fixed on linear programming problems. Okay. So go through the examples, practice them once again. And thank you.